Hello everyone, welcome. In this lesson, we are going to learn the different situations in which we must use the ing form. Let's see the first point, the progressive form. Let's say that the ing form is used in the present progressive, the past progressive, and the present perfect progressive. Let's see it with some examples. We are playing football. This sentence is in the present progressive. She was cooking potatoes, that is in the past progressive. And finally, I have been living in Ouagadougou since my birth. So this example is in the present perfect progressive. So when we use one of these sentences, we must make sure that we are using the ing form. Let's see the second one. ing is also used after verbs of perception, such as to see, to look, to hear, to feel, to taste, to listen, to watch, and so on. And when we are using a verb of perception, we must refer to the following structure: subject plus verb plus object plus verb ing. And in this situation, it is used to indicate that an action is being perceived. Let's see it with following examples. I see him dancing. I hear her calling. I feel my tooth moving. So when I say I see him dancing, it means that there is an action that is being perceived by me. So it is the same with the other examples. Number three, ing form is also used in the present participles used as adjectives. We have the examples of adjectives such as interesting, exciting, boring, amazing, annoying, and so on. So in English, most of present participles used as adjectives are formed with the ing form. But note that it is not all these adjectives, but most of them have the same structure. Example, this story is very interesting. Paul is in a worrying situation. Martin Luther King gave an inspiring speech. So you can see that here all these adjectives are used as present participles, and they are also all ended by ing form. Now, let's see this times now, the ing form is used with the gerund. And first, let's try to give a short definition of a gerund. Let's say that a gerund is a verb which is ended in ing and is used like a noun. A gerund can be used as the subject of a sentence. Example, swimming is my favorite pastime. Drinking much alcohol is not good for health. So here we can see that the gerund is used in both examples as the subject of the sentences. A gerund can also be used to express the way or the fact of doing something. His eating is disgusting. I like your speaking. His failing his exam is disappointing. So here we can see that these examples means the way of doing something or the fact of doing something. For example, when I say his eating is disgusting, I could, for example, say also, his way of eating is disgusting. And when I say, I like your speaking, that means I like your way of speaking. And he is failing his exam is disappointing. I can say, the fact that he failed his exam is disappointing. So each of these examples means the way of doing something or the fact of doing something. And in this cases, we must use the ing form. Three, a gerund is also used after some prepositions such as after, from, before, by, in spite of, on, without, in, about, and so many other prepositions. For example, when I say, I went to the office after having my breakfast. The guest left without eating. His head prevents me from watching the movie. I succeeded in building my house. So we can see here that every time we use One of these prepositions, the verb that follows is ended by ing form. Number four. Gerund is also used after verbs such as to stop, to continue, to avoid, to detest, to like, to dislike, to hate, to feel like, to keep, to endure, to finish, and so many other verbs like that. So when we use one of these verbs, we must make sure that the verb that is following is a form with the ing form. Example, we must keep moving forward. I like traveling abroad. So we can see here that we have used these verbs, and we will say that after these verbs, we must use the ing form. And let's move to the fifth point. The gerund is used after some expressions such as I can stand or I can't bear, I can't help, it's no use, it's no good, it's no worth, and so on. And for example, when I say it's no use crying over spilled milk, I can help looking at the picture, he can stand seeing cats. So we can see that here every time we have used one of these expressions, the verb that follow is ended by ing. So also you when you use one of these expressions, you must make sure that you are using the ing form after that. Thank you. We are at the end of our lesson of the day. Thank you for your attention, and see you next time for another lesson.